Martin Scorsese once described The Age of Innocence as his most violent film he has ever made. And you can see that why. This film isn't about the physical violence that Scorsese is known to show in his films, but rather, this film is about the emotional violence of unrequited love that, just like the characters in this film, we all go through. In an interview given to Roger Ebert, Scorsese elaborated on this point, saying, "What has always stuck in my mind is the brutality under the manners. People hide what they mean under the surface of language." Based on the book of the same name, written by Edith Wharton, The Age of Innocence tells the story, set in 19th century New York, about Newland Archer, who falls in love with Countess Ellen Olenska, who is separated from her husband, while Archer is engaged to Ellen's cousin, May Welland. Because of the rigid codes of aristocratic society, where the notion of what is proper easily reigns over the notions of truth or love, Archer fights a never-ceasing inner battle waged between a desperately longing heart and the social decorum he's an inherent part of. The Age of Innocence might be Scorsese's most underappreciated or underrated movie that he has ever made. When people talk about Scorsese, they don't really talk about The Age of Innocence as much as they should be. There are a lot of people out there who feel like Scorsese only makes gangster films, but if you take his whole filmography, then you will know that he doesn't really have a set specific genre that he makes movies on. His movies are a culmination of the art he always strives to show us in his films. The Age of Innocence is a story of unrequited passion, with Archer's decades-long love for Ellen driving forward through societal, personal, and professional transformations that affect the characters along the way. Archer dreams of spending his life with Ellen, leaving everything and everyone behind. But Ellen cannot betray her family's trust and break her cousin's heart, because true love is not selfish, and so she lets him go. Archer's character is something we all can recognize with, a person wanting the love he cannot have in his life. Archer has to sacrifice the love of his life to do the right thing, and manages to be content. Newland's internal journey is best reflected by the following pattern: happiness, the sudden introduction of something new, discontentment, and longing for new, reconciliation with the old, and then contentment again. The final scene on a park bench in Paris contains a revelation showing that love is more complex and secret than we imagine. Maybe the story of love imagined but never realized will resound greater with an audience living through a bleak time in human history, where most of us feel a sense of lost for experiences which will now exist only in the realm of imagination. Newland's own struggle mirrors our own melancholy. To see him sitting peacefully on a park bench in Paris as he ponders the life he could have, but we as the audience are only left with the feeling that he will die satisfied of having felt, if only for a moment, that a love of such intensity is possible. If you like watching this video, consider subscribing to the channel to watch more videos like this.